get them like God. Hey, total marriage job, try to get another watch. Damn it, I'm so hot. Man, I can't be stopped. Made a million off of rocks, and I really shoot at ops. In the end, I'm really rock. Still shoot my job. Ain't got a clock. Shooting at my eyes. Get a lot of God.
What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we are going to be talking about the worst customer service fucking experience I've ever had in my entire life. Actually, probably not my entire life, but it comes pretty motherfucking close. So I was supposed to tell this story yesterday because I was in the moment, I was mad, I was ready. But I was like, you know what, I need to calm my ass down. Like, a bitch was ready to give out business names. A bitch was ready to fucking call the BBB. A bitch was ready. Okay, I don't even know. Could you call the BBB on bodegas? Like, so I was at work or whatever, and down the street from my job, there is a bodega, there's a corner store. So I'm gonna interchange the words corner store and bodega maybe a lot in this story. If you don't know what a bodega is, it's a corner store. If you don't know what a corner store is, it's a bodega. You know what I mean? It's a store. They sell sandwiches, and I was hungry. So I'm currently intermittent fasting. If you don't know what intermittent fasting is, it's basically where you restrict a certain time of your day to eat. I only eat from 12 p.m. to 7 p.m. Before 12 p.m., I do not eat. After 7 p.m., I do not eat. It actually helps lower your insulin levels or regulate your insulin levels. It helps lower your calorie intake. It does a whole lot of different shit. Google it. I'm not here for that. This is not a health channel. The whole point is I'm intermittent fasting. I was starving. I get to work around 10 something. I couldn't eat for 2 more hours. I was fucking hungry. So I was like, you know what? Let me go get my ass a sandwich. I work at a doctor's office, and we stopped taking patients at about 12 o'clock. So I decided I'm gonna go run out around 11, it was like 11:20. So I ran, went to go get this sandwich because I didn't want to bother anyone at 12 to come open doors, lock doors, all that extra shit. So I was like, you know what, let me be considerate. Let me go get my sandwich now, right? So I go to the little bodega or whatever, and I've been going to this bodega for years. I literally been there like forever, like since before I worked at my job, I used to go to this corner store. Like, it has changed owners over the years, and I still went to this specific corner store. I never had no motherfucking problems with nobody. I'm cool with almost everybody that works in that fucking store. So I go to the store, and I walk in, and I walk to the back. So I walk to the back, and the guy is not there. So I go to the front, and I'm like, hey, yo, like, who's supposed to be making my sandwich? Are you making my sandwich? Because sometimes the person in the front does go to the back if there's, like, no one there. But usually there's another sandwich person there. And he's like, oh, no. So he calls the guy out. The guy comes out. He already look annoyed. He already look angry. But I'm like, you know what? He's like, whatever. This nigga's just here to make my sandwich. He ain't gonna give me no motherfucking problems. So I'm on my phone, and he's like, what do you want? What kind of sandwich do you want, hot or cold? I'm like, all right, why not? Let's do a hot sandwich today. He goes, okay, what would you like on it? I'm like, I want pastrami and provolone. And he's like, oh, okay, what kind of sandwich do you want? And I'm like, pastrami. At this point, he's putting his gloves on or whatever, and he's going to the meat. So like, there's like a whole thing of glass. It's like the grill thing here, and it is like a thing of glass where all the meats are. So he walks over, and he's asking me again, what kind of meat? And I'm just like, what the fuck? Like, didn't I just say that? But you know, at this point, I'm still like, I'm not mad, but I'm just like, bruh. At this point, he's like, oh, you need to get off your phone if you need to do something. Strike one. That's strike one. What the fuck does my phone have to do with you giving me a hot pastrami motherfucking sandwich with provolone? I fucking told you I want a hot pastrami sandwich with provolone. What the fuck does my phone have to do with shit? So I'm like, excuse me? And he was like, nothing, nothing. What do you want? I said, hot pastrami and provolone. I'm still calm at this point. I'm chilling. I ain't got no problems. I just want my sandwich. So then he goes on the grill. He puts the pastrami on there. We chilling, whatever. And he's like, yeah, everything on it. I was like, everything but onions. He goes, mayonnaise, ketchup. I'm sorry, but everything, doesn't everything include mayonnaise, ketchup, everything, like tomatoes, lettuce, but onions? Like, I'm confused. I'm very, at this point, I'm just like, didn't I just, bitch, like, so I'm like, yes. And then he goes, lettuce. I'm like, yes. Tomatoes, yes. Onions, no. And mind you, I didn't even catch an attitude. I'm telling you, inside, I wanted to be like, I fucking said everything, sir. I fucking said everything. But you know what? I was still being calm. So he goes and he puts a big ass block of fucking American cheese, and he starts slicing. And I'm like, sir, I said provolone cheese. And this is where shit goes the fuck left. He's like, no, you didn't. Guys, what cheese did I say I wanted on my sandwich? Please tell me. Pause this video and comment down below. Comment what it was that I said that I wanted on my sandwich, because I'm very sure I was very clear on what I wanted on my fucking sandwich. I said it at least 3 times. I'm like, yes, I did. I said provolone cheese. I'm still calm. This is exactly what I'm talking about. I'm like, yes, I did. I said provolone cheese. I want provolone cheese on my sandwich. No, you didn't. No, you didn't. No, you didn't, mommy. No, no, no. You said American cheese. You said American cheese.
Remember, nope, sir, I definitely said I wanted provolone. I said provolone numerous times.
No, no, you lie. You lie, mommy. No, you lie. You lie. If you ever wanna see me mad, call me names. I swear to God, call me names, but yeah, call me a liar. If you ever wanna see me mad, call me a liar. There is nothing that pisses me off more than anything when someone says that I'm lying. Don't you ever call me a liar, because I'm one of the most honest people you will ever meet in your entire life. Don't call me a liar, especially if you don't know me. Do not say that I'm lying. I don't even lie to my hoes. Like, what are you talking about? Like, so at this point, I'm just like, excuse me? The Elizabeth came out of me. The Haitian came out of me. The ratchet came out of me. Cognac. Qui qualité de respect Monsieur Sabdim la? Sa like, who the fuck you think you're talking to? Like, that's how everything came out, bruh. I personally don't understand what's wrong with him. I'm not the source of this man's pain. I don't know why he acting like that. But he need to take that shit somewhere else, because I'm not the motherfucking one. I don't know if he expected me not to answer. I don't know if he expected me not to buck back. But a bitch was ready to buck the fuck back today. Like, I didn't give a shit. Like, I was literally ready to hit him. Like, that's how mad I was. Like, you're not about to yell at me over some dumb shit like provolone and American cheese. What the fuck do I have to lie to you? Like, why do I have to lie about that? That's nothing to lie about. I was like, excuse me. Now I put my phone in my back pocket. See, now I could put my phone away. I said, excuse me, sir. I was like, how am I lying? Just because you did not understand me does not mean I'm lying. Just because you did not hear me does not mean that I am lying. I definitely said provolone cheese. I don't even lie to my hoes. So what makes you think I'm about to lie to you? Who are you? Like, what did you, like, I don't even know who you are. I don't know what satisfaction would I get out of saying that I said provolone instead of American cheese. First of all, American cheese and provolone don't even fucking sound the same. Second of all, what am I getting out of saying that I wanted provolone and not American cheese? Third of all, what is your problem? Like, I don't know what's happening. I don't know if his bitch got him mad. I don't know if he just got put on child support. I don't know if he ain't getting no bitches. He ain't getting no pussy. He need to get his dick wet. Like, I don't know what his problem is. I am just livid at this point. I was like, don't you ever in your life open your mouth to tell me that I am a liar because you did not understand what I'm saying. And he's going back and forth with me. He's really going back and forth. Oh, you a liar. You a liar, mommy. No, you a liar. I understand English. I understand English. I'm like, clearly you don't. I didn't say that to him. You said American cheese. You said American cheese. I said provolone. Sorry, no. I'm like, sir, I'm sorry if you're having a bad day, but that's not my problem. If you're having a bad day, that is your business. I have nothing to do with that. Keep that to yourself. Keep that energy to yourself. I said provolone. He's just really arguing, like, he's really going back and forth with me. So then the guy in the front of the store is sitting here laughing and shit, talking to him, oh no, leave my boy alone. I'm like, your boy is disrespectful. He's calling me a liar. He's yelling at me. This is the worst customer service I've ever had in my life. I've been coming to the store for years. I don't understand this type of behavior. And you think this shit is funny? I will walk the fuck out right now. Y'all will never see me or any of the patients who come to my doctor's office ever again at this establishment because you think this shit's so funny. Oh no, at this point, everybody's calming down their voices. Ain't nobody laughing no more. Ain't nobody mad no more. Ain't nobody yelling no more. Oh no, mommy, mommy, calm down. Mommy, mommy, calm down. Oh no, I make the sandwich good for you. I make the sandwich good. Come here, come here, come here. No, 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 no. I'm like, nah, bitch, nah, nah, nah. Like, fuck you, me. Like, I mean, part of me wanted to just walk smooth out that store. Like, I really didn't even care for the sandwich at that point because I was just so freaking mad. I don't like people calling me names. I don't like when people don't listen, and I don't like when people try to, like, call, like, say that it's my fault, or like, oh, I'm on my phone, which is why I didn't understand, or I'm not doing something right because I'm on my phone. That's ridiculous. I told you what I needed and I said everything. There was no reason for you to even talk to me after that. Hot pastrami, provolone, everything but onions. How hard is that to understand? How? You know, he finishes the sandwich, he gives it to me, tells him have a nice day or whatever.
I go to the front, I pay for it. He's like, and the guy in the front's like, oh man, I'm so sorry about that, you know, and I'm sorry for laughing. I'm like, nah, you ain't gonna catch me here again. You guys are disrespectful. This is the worst establishment ever, and you guys are rude. Fuck y'all. I ain't got time for this. Well, I didn't say fuck y'all, but I was just like, I'm not coming back here ever again. You guys will never get my service. I'm not a fan of you guys. That was rude. And the fact that you think that is funny, it's disgusting. And I walked out. So honestly, that was really one of the worst customer service situations I've ever been in. There's probably more, but I just can't think about them. But like, seriously, I don't understand why people act that way. I don't know if this nigga had a bad day. I don't know if his bitch left him. I don't know if he just got bought on child support. I don't know if his dick fell off. I don't know what his problem was, but this nigga was completely mad. He was mad when he came out to make the sandwich in the first place, so maybe he was already in a bad mood. But my thing is, if you work in customer service or in general, if you're in a bad mood, do not take that bad mood or that bad energy onto other people. That's just disrespectful as fuck. I was absolutely angry. I don't think anybody understands how angry I was yesterday. I'm not going back to that store. Those people pissed me off, and yeah, like, they don't deserve anybody's business, but I'm not gonna throw their shit under the bus, but whatever.